Okay, so the basic principle behind making a normal map from an image, white protrudes and black recedes. This provides 256 tonal variations if we just use straightforward grayscale, which then means some relatively complex shapes and forms can be created that can be turned into normal maps. Although a height map could be used to do this, it's preferential to create a dedicated image that will be filtered using a normal map converter. There are subtle differences that don't always come through, but it's worth the effort because the template can still be used for other things. So what can be seen in the video is just the process of putting together a number of basic shapes, layering them together so that we create a sense of depth and height. In this instance, it's just for a very basic truss support. Once this is completed, the image will be flattened and then either copied and pasted into another application or saved to a lossless format like TGA or TIFF and then imported for processing. It will be converted to a normal map, in this instance using NJob. There isn't really too much to discuss from this point onward, so it's best just to sit back and watch the process. There will be a bit more audio towards the end of the video, so watch out for that. Once the structure is complete, it's important to change the background color. Ideally, this should be black, but it can be a tone representing the maximum depth expected from the normal map. So depending on your photo editing application, just flood fill the background or an object or layer to get the result needed. So before flattening the image, make sure that this is done. Once the image is flattened, copy, open up NJob, and then paste the copied data into the workspace, and then run the height map to normal map filter. Change the settings as needed, altering the intensity, sharpness, softness of the normal map, although here called scale and blur radius, they do the same thing. OK to set it in place, and then save. Make sure to use a lossless or non-compressed image format to ensure that the normal map has no artifacts introduced into it, which can cause problems. By way of testing the result, the normal map can then be loaded in as a normal map for a standard material under Blender Game Engine and GLSL being set. It allows the texture to be affected by the normal map.